Hi guys, so as you may see, my hair is super crazy right now. It looks awful, and that is because I have just brushed it with this comb, and the reason why I have done that is because I am going to be doing a video on my new colours. Yay! These are from Nikki Clark, it's the Mayfair collection. I mentioned it in my previous video, which I will link in the down bar for you. So basically this is just a wand with a wand contraption with three different ones to choose from. First of all, you have the smallest wand, which is this one here. This will create tight ringlets. I'm not a big fan of the tight ringlets, but I'm going to show you what every curling like one of these does anyway and build it up to the bigger one. The second one is this one here, which is more for like a medium kind of curl. And then the last one is this big one here. This is my favourite. It creates beautiful curls. The main part of the curling wand thing is this here. It has this super lovely glittery sort of base bit, and it just has a simple on off like switch. Inside this box it also comes with like a little instruction leaflet, nothing too big, only a few pages, and it just basically tells you what part is what and how to use it, health and safety, all that jazz, and that's it really. To be honest, this is pretty simple and it's easy to use. Okay, so I washed my hair yesterday and I've recently combed for it, which is why it's all bushy. But when it comes to curling your hair, it's always best to do it with not super clean hair because it makes the curls not stay as long. So to keep it to stay as long, I use a few different products, and that is Curl Definition by Aussie, and then there's also Awesome Volume. Yeah, basically I just start with the Curl Definition. On the back it has the directions on how to use it, and it says shake well before use, which I'm gonna do now. And you can use this on wet or dry hair. I prefer using it on wet hair just because, I don't know, I feel like if I'm using it on dry hair it's gonna make it really greasy. But I didn't use it yesterday, so I'm gonna use it now. Use a pea size amount, I don't know if you can see that, in your hand. Rub it together and then just work through your hair. It smells so amazing. It smells really fresh and lovely. It smells so lovely, and it doesn't really leave your hair feeling greasy, it just gives it a bit more of an easier texture to work with. The product I use after I use the curling serum is what I mentioned earlier, Mousse Hair. Now I'm not going to use this now because it's best to be used on damp hair. Because my hair's dry, I don't want to cause it to dry out a bit too much and then frizz even more on the curling thing. I'm going to start with the smaller wand and then work my way up to the larger one. You do have to wait for the wands to cool down once you change them, so it's going to take me a little bit longer to do this, but that's fine because I want to show you how each curling wand does what it does. They're really easy to put in. All you do is, if you can see in here, I'm not entirely sure, which matches this outer sort of look here. So you just match it up together, push it in, and then you twirl this bit here towards yourself, and then that locks the wand in. So it's now locked in, and then to pull it out, you literally just plonk it the other way. So really simple, really easy, just like that. Now, I haven't got anyone to help me with getting the angles close into this, so I'm afraid I'm just gonna have to sit here and maybe lean a bit closer into the camera for you to see what I'm doing. It doesn't take too long for the wand to heat up, but as you can see here, it has this blue light just to say that it is heating up. I'm gonna wait a minute just for this to heat up, and then I will kick straight into it. So I've separated my hair into a section here, and this is where I'm gonna be doing the smaller curling for you. I'm just gonna give it a quick comb through as well. So I assume this is heated up now. It would be really cool if it comes with a beeping device to let you know that it's heated, but it doesn't. But it's been heating for about a minute now, so I'm gonna kick straight into this and hope it's hot enough. So I have a mirror there and there, so I won't be looking at the camera, I'll be looking at the mirrors, but let's see how we do. I also don't have a I also don't have a thing for my hand, so you will be seeing me wrap this around my hair really stupidly. So as you can see, it's just wrapped around, not in the nicest ways, but I'm not really entirely sure either how long to leave these on here for, but this is extremely tight, this curl. So whether you can see it or not, I'm not sure. So I'm now gonna move that out of the way and try and show you a lot better to do it. So. Oh, I'm so scared of burning myself.
again, I'm not entirely sure on how long to leave it, but...
So I've curled all this section of my hair now and it's created this really tight ringlet look to it. With this, it does the job really well. Like if you see this one looks lovely. This tight ringlet here. So it does really good on doing the really tight ringlets. I'm just gonna let this cool down and then I'm gonna move on to the next sort of one, which is this one here. And I just drop it. So I have moved on to the next curling one and that is the medium one here. It's currently heating up. So whilst it heats up, I'm gonna create another section of my hair to curl this one with. Okay, now that this is heated, I'm gonna move on to curling this part of my hair. Some of you are probably watching this thinking I do my hair really in a really stupid way. But to be honest, so many people have different ways of curling their hair, and this is just what personally works best for me. And that is the curl there. So I have finished curling this part of my hair with this wand and I absolutely love this wand. So lovely. The ringlets are just the perfect amount of tightness. They're like, oh, they're just so pretty. So moving on from that wand, I am now going to go to the biggest wand and I'm going to do the top part of my hair with this. So I've changed over the wand to the thickest one, which is this one here. And I'm just going to let this heat up again and just sort my hair out to curl it. Separating the fringe, and then I'm just gonna comb through that as well. Right, so this should hopefully be heated up and I'm gonna start the closest one to you guys this time. And then it just creates a very similar curl to the medium one, but just that little bit bigger. That's all those curls there, like that. I'll try to sort of stand up so you can see how they look at the bottom as well. So I'm just gonna finish off this side now. Okay. So that's all my hair curled. Unfortunately, my camera's run out of battery, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna finish off this side without recording so that my camera can charge, and then I'm gonna curl my fringe last for you. For this side of my hair, I am gonna do the exact same technique I done with this side. However, the full thing I'm just gonna record. I'm just gonna curl with the big one rather than changing barrels, just because it'll be easier. So I will see you once I have done this side of my hair. Okay, so I managed to charge my camera and it's sort of decent on the whole charging thing, and I've curled this side of my hair. So all of these curls on this side of my hair here, I'll stand up a bit as well, are all from the larger barreled curling wand, and that is this large one here that I mentioned earlier. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get my fringe from this side of my head, so I'm not gonna have middle parting, and I'm gonna curl my fringe to this side so that I have a side curly fringe. So that is my fringe now, not curly. I am just gonna pin the hair that is curly out of the way. All that back like that as well. So I have my main focus here. And I'm just gonna start from this little bit. Ooh. Just wrap it round. I'm not gonna leave it on for too long because I don't want my fringe to be too curly. I just want it to be a bit more wavy. I feel like it's actually easier to do the hair closest to my face because I can actually, I don't know, I can get the swing a lot better than if it's a bit too far behind my hair. I'm just gonna adapt the curls together a bit, and then I have my curled fringe
there. So now I'm just gonna release the hair. I'm just gonna zhuzh it around a little bit just to get it all in together. Oh god, this curl's a bit weird. So that is the curl in my fringe there. Now I've got my curls here, this is how it looks, and I'm just gonna push this back here. Okay, I'm just gonna brush the tips of my hair just a little bit just so my hair isn't too up close and it's a bit that has a bit more of a length to it. And to get a bit of hold, I'm gonna use High Hold High Shine Hairspray by Aussie. And I'm just gonna spray that a little bit into my hair. So there you have it. You have the curls from the Nikki Clark Mayfair collection. But yeah, thank you for watching this video. I hope you liked it. If you did, give it a thumbs up. And if you're considering buying it, I would definitely recommend you do. Thanks again for watching. Bye.